Sorry.
Yeah, good.
Innovation in malaria is needed because, as in other therapeutic areas, there is a lot of resistance to current anti-malarial treatments. So innovative and effective solutions are needed.
To be able to combat malaria and to be able to achieve the goals of malaria eradication, it is not sufficient to have just one solution. We need to have something called a toolbox for solving the problem of malaria.
It's a very important part to find new molecules and new ways of treatment in order to avoid those resistant parasites that are already emerging in different areas of the world.
Fenaquim, which is actually to do what's called radical cure of a specific form of malaria called 5-ax malaria. And radical cure means you completely get rid of both the blood form, but also the form that disappears inside the liver. And 5-ax malaria is one of the malaria forms that is potentially able to be eliminated, hopefully within the next few years.
GSK's RTSS vaccine is the first ever vaccine to be licensed against malaria, and it's a huge scientific breakthrough. My hope is that we can leverage all of the expertise that GSK has accrued in the development of a first generation vaccine and apply that to a new second generation vaccine product. Vaccines alone are not enough to target malaria. We need combinations of drugs, vaccines, bed nets, and other interventions in order to bring this problem under control. But vaccines are a huge step forward in that toolbox.
Deltiris suruhetensis TC1 was discovered in mosquitoes from Arthres cantos insectarii, which were incapable of transmitting malaria. Over time, our colony lost its ability to get infected by the malaria parasite, and we found the predominance of one particular bacteria, which we identified as Deltia.
If we get the bacteria out in the field and the mosquito gets infected with this bacteria, that mosquito won't transmit malaria. So you have prevention, treatment, vector, and diagnostics. When you have that, you can ring-fence the disease and approach elimination.
And have one purpose, which is at the end, the patient, and to treat them, to get a medicine that they will be able to reduce or ideally eliminate the malaria.